Podnas with Face, Pat, and Tiz.
This week, I'm coming with something I'm calling Tiz's Matrix. What we're going to do is every week for a little bit, I'm going to be bringing one tenet of red pill ideology and discussing it with what I consider two real men and seeing if the tenet is, if it holds up, like, yes, this is something that a real man should follow, or it holds weight, or if it is straight bullshit. And by the end of this journey, the goal is to debunk the bullshit about what manhood is and settle on some real man criteria that, like, makes sense for men to actually follow, that will actually get them through society in the world we live in today in 2022. So, yeah, the first tenet of red pill ideology that we are going to dig into is, they believe that men are beta or a secondary male if they are not the provider of the house. Do we agree with that? Is that viable? Is that bullshit? Or is it viable back in the day and just doesn't hold weight anymore? Either one of the partners can jump on that one first.
I would have to say, for a lot of that stuff that they say beta and alpha about, I almost feel like you would have to feel beta to completely believe all of that shit that they say, because it completely rule out circumstance.
That's real.
Like, that it completely rules out circumstance. Like, anything can happen to you and put you in a place where you're beta now. You know, you could be the richest person and the craziest thing can happen to you. And next thing you know, you can't supply for yourself unless you that insanely rich that you got pulled like that. But it's not that many people out there like that. If that's the case, then it's a handful of alphas out there, and it's all because they're rich. I don't think you can really place that type of categorizing of men or whatever, and that, I don't know, it's freaking degrading. It sounds like the shit that they used to do with slaves or whatever, you know, mandingos and this, that, and the third. Like, it just, that categorizing of stuff, it just but if I will say this, if you as a man, you instinctually want to be a provider. If a circumstance have you in a situation where you're not the immediate provider at that time, your man brain's going to kick in and try to do something to accompany what can be done to provide until you get to a point where you are the provider. Your goal in your head is to provide you for yourself. Because it is, as a man, you don't think, like, you don't normally think, hey, I can count on this person. You automatically think, I'm the only person I can think of that can help me right now. First, not to say that we don't have friends and family and this, that, and the third. But the first thing you're thinking of, I have to do this, me, as a man. Or whatever. So I guess if you don't have that mentality, maybe you're beta. Mm. But if you're talking about straight up, right now I'm not the provider or whatever, or this, that, and the third, or you're just looking at somebody because of their circumstance right then and there, I can't categorize with that. It just seemed like some degrading shit to me, if you get what I mean. I don't know if I'm running out of tangent, but that's, yep.
Gotcha. Face Mom, what you think?
I lean towards what Pat says, for us being more situational. But at that same time, it being more to like to each his own. Some people accept the role of being bigger and just kowtow to their woman, whatever they say, you feel me? And have no standing at all. But your financial presence to me in the household gains no bearing as far as alpha or beta. You could be the sole provider and still be a simp with your money and be stupid as fuck and not run your household and be ran over. So in essence, you could still be the provider and be a beta. Just because you go make the money don't mean you provide it. And just because you're not making the money doesn't mean you're not the one making the decisions about what is done with the money. You're not the one running the household. As far as the term alpha and beta being linked with who has the sole providership, like I said, I think that's a humdrum old ass term. Really, really old. Really, really outdated. Back in the day where a real man went out and did this, but a real man didn't know how to do anything in the household, where nowadays a man has to know how to do everything outside the house, inside the house, and know how to get a dollar. So, because at the end of the day, you feel me? Like, you gotta know how to take care of yourself, man. You gotta have skills to survive. Like, I don't know how nobody else parents raised them, but my mother raised me to be able to take care of the house outside the house and go outside and make the money to do for the house. You feel me? So I mean, that's just natural skill for me. I don't know if that makes me an alpha or a beta, but I mean, like, I do what I need to do to take care of my household. That categorizing shit between the two. I mean, I see what they mean in people. But as far as on an everyday scale, I feel like everybody has their both moments. So in a household, if you in the house with your woman, y'all, it's a give and take anyway. So one of y'all going to be a beta at some point. One of y'all going to be an alpha at some point. So that's just how I see shit.
That's real. I think I definitely agree with y'all. So I think we're going to end up leaning that this is a bullshit tenant. But I ended up looking up like alpha and beta male just to make sure that I had the correct definition, because you know, I'd be stuck on semantics like shit. So I looked it up, and basically an alpha male is a male that takes a dominant, domineering leadership role in a society or in a household or in a animal group. A beta male is one that takes a subordinate role in a society, animal group, household. So with that being said, I'm looking at it like finances, for one, has nothing to do with those two terms. Dominant, subordinate. Those are two very specific positions or hierarchies in a society. Like, you are either one of the people who are stepping up and stepping forward to lead something or to run something or to initiate something or to do something, or you are the one stepping back and following what someone else is doing for you or doing, and you're taking that. So I think that's very clear. Like, most men I know that we would consider men, I think that's what it really boiled down to in that case, being like, most men I know would be alpha in that case, because most men I know, even in a grouping of themselves, it's a constant, like, everybody standing on their own squares. Nobody like, oh, well, I'm gonna do what you say, you know what I'm saying? So I think it's the go along, the get along mentality, as Kwame Brown would call it. Like, that type of, I will just roll with what my woman says. Even if I'm the one making all the money, I might be paying every bill, making all the money, buying all the cars, clothes, all that, and still following what she said. Then I'm still a beta, like Faye said, like that still fits that role. So I think when you define alpha and beta, I think the first tenet goes out the window.
Mm-hmm.
Alpha or beta, for one, we really just established two things. For one, finances have nothing to do with your rank in your house or in society in general. For two, alpha and beta have an actual definition. So people can't keep running around saying, I'm an alpha male, but you're you're following behind some other dude. Like, even when you look at them, what's the dude, Fresh and Fit, like, mm-hmm. there's a clear dynamic there. Like, they're not on equal playing fields. Like, one says something, the other one just parrots it. He never has a difference of opinion. He never even has his own opinion. Half the time, he doesn't even answer a question until after he hears what the other one says, and then it's like, oh, yep, that's what I think, too. Yep, that's a beta mentality, like, to me. Like, and I don't care how much money nobody got in that situation. That following mentality is what I would consider beta. So, like, yeah, I think we kicked that one out of here. So, tenet one of the red pill is actually some blue pill shit, because it still got you stuck on some bullshit instead of following the truth. Alpha have a definition. And it's not your finances that determine that. It's how you are moving as a man. Are you moving in a position where you are stepping up, initiating things, leading things, or standing on your own two and push and driving something? Or are you taking a back seat and riding along the wave? And that determines. So there, red pill community, tenet one, sadly, debunked. Get your ass out of here. Next up, next week on The Matrix, I think we'll be digging more into how they feel about the ladies.